And it's the role of the parents to give the children a stable ground to stand upon.
Back on marriage, yeah. Marriage, like, it's something that is God-given. How would you describe marriage?
Yeah,
just to start from that.
You said it. Marriage is an institution that was given by God. The Bible says, and in the beginning, God made man. He created man, male and female. The accounts in the book of Genesis chapter 2 tells us that God created man first, the man, and then he gave him, he thought it is not good to be, for man to be alone. So he created all the animals and all the other living creatures who are creeping, swimming, walking, flying, and he brought them to man, for man to name them. And the Bible says that there was not a mate found among those animals who will help, who will be the nature of man. So God let man fall in a sleep and took a rib of man and built. The Bible says built is that is the Hebrew translation, says built. It created man and built woman from the man. So that was the picture of how God wanted the family to be. And he said, man needs a helpmate. I need to go back to the Bible and just read this very particular translation that I've searched into from the Hebrew perspective of the word. It's in the Genesis chapter 2 verse 18. It says, "The Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone, Adam. I shall make a helper for him corresponding to him." This is the word that is in from the Hebrew. The word corresponding is the word keneged. Keneged. K-E-N-E-G-E-D. Keneged. It means a meaning being equal to and adequate for. So God made woman being equal to man, adequate to help him fulfill the purpose that he had for man. What is the purpose that God had for man? He told man to tender the garden and so he told, it's in Genesis 1:27. He said, so God created mankind in his own image. He created him in the image of God. He created them male and female. And God blessed them and said to them, "Be fruitful, multiply, fill the earth, subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the fowl of the air and over every living thing that moves upon the earth." That was the purpose that God has given mankind. And the woman was to help him fulfill that purpose. So this is the institution of marriage. It is God-given. And man shall leave mother and father, and therefore man will leave his father and his mother and will cling to his wife, and they will be one flesh. That is Genesis 2, verse 24. Because Adam saw in the woman and said, "This is the bone of my bone and the flesh of my flesh." This is the biblical definition of marriage.
Okay. So, since we've heard from the Bible that marriage was made by God, Is it possible for someone to make a wrong move in marriage as a Christian, maybe choose the wrong partner after following the parameters of the scriptures?
Yes, I believe that because we are spirits who live in the flesh. We live in a body, not flesh. We live in a body, which is our shelter, who gives us access to this word. We can, if we are not mature enough, we can be led astray to do wrong choices. And in the area of marriage, my advice to single people, to young people, is that seek God first and be committed to have the right purpose of you getting married that God has in mind for you. It is to fulfill God's purpose for your life, that you will get married. It is not for you to have to be able to have sex without being guilty. It is not just for you not to avoid being lonely. It is for you to fulfill God's purpose in your life, that you need a mate. And when the right time comes, you will know that this is the right time in the inside of you with the witness of the Holy Spirit, and then you will be open to see, to meet the one God will bring to you. But I want to let you know, as the Bible says, that we should not mingle with unbelievers. The first criteria of your mate must be a believer in Christ. If you are a believer in Christ, you cannot go and take an unbeliever. That is pre-programming you for catastrophe in that area of your life.
Great. Also, I heard from the definition in the Bible that Eve was made equal to Adam, right? But we have this issue of equality right now in the world. What can you say about that?
So, we are equal in calling to God, for God. Equal in calling, but different in purpose. That is a fundamental thing that we have to understand. Man has his purpose. As God has called man to lead the family, to be the leader, to be the priest, to be the high priest, to be the shaman, or not that generation, to be the chief, to be the king, and so. And man has called woman to be the leader in the house, to be the one helping. Keeping the family together, keeping the things concerning the life of the society together, because society begins in the family. Mm-hmm. And God has made women with certain strength and men with other strength. There is no weaker vessel. The Bible says the woman is weaker vessel, is true, but in the sense of one needs to be dominated by the other. No, it is just when the apostle says the woman is a weaker vessel, it's just a sense of the purpose of man to be the protective one over the woman. That is why Paul recalled the woman as a weaker vessel. Man has to be a protective vessel, a protective one for the woman. And that it's called for purpose, not for who will at the end of the day, there has to be somebody who will be the head.
Mm.
But the purpose is the question, is the basic for the fundamental issue in this thing.
Very good. Speaking of leadership and headship, how do you balance between love and leadership?
Yeah, very good question. So it depends. And every couple has to define it for herself. We have defined the balance between it according to the biblical principle. We discuss our decisions, and then we make the decisions, and I, as the husband, takes responsibility for the decisions. And we are sharpening each other, and we are working on working more as a team.
Great. You spoke about sharpening each other. In marriage, we know that there are a lot of challenges that come. How do you sharpen each other in marriage? How do you live together?
So, coming from a cultural background, different cultural backgrounds, and also having a completely different set of upbringing behind us, this is a constant challenge. Even I can hear it from many mixed couples, to always find the right middle in every discussion, in every differences that one has, and the primary attitude is that my upbringing, the standard that I have received